Like that. Hey, something new I want to talk about.
Something new, indeed. Baritone. Heard a little bit about baritones. In fact, we gave a sneak peek of the baritones in a ply shell a couple NAMs ago. Chris had a prototype kit done very, very last minute. Sounded probably the best thing at that time, at that point, that he'd ever made. He'd been raving about it. I came back to Perth. It looked a little bit like a dog's breakfast at the time because it was a prototype model, and he was adamant it was going to NAM, the be-all and end-all, without any sort of idea as to when it would be available, how many we could build, what materials they come out of, do they come in any other colors, or any other actual, you know, necessary information. But he put the kit out. Phenomenal sounding kit, prototype kit. Half of it is still back with him. The other half is in Los Angeles with me. I have one rack tom and a bass drum, which Chris Dave takes out a lot. It's just this 20-inch killer bass drum used on the BET Awards as well. Phenomenal sounding stuff. From a ply shell point of view, it still needs a couple of tweaks before I think it's ready to be put out into the market. But in the meantime, they decided that they should maybe try applying the same concepts to a block drum. And how would that work? How would it sound?
So it's basically a block drum, but you carve the middle out more?
Yeah, or? I mean, a block drum is standard half an inch thick anyway. So if you carve the middle out, what happens with the shell is that it doesn't tend to recognize the half an inch. Kind of more only recognizes the quarter of an inch. It's a funny system the way it works. And the baritone block drums are sort of somewhere between a standard block drum and a standard ply drum. It's a way of lowering the note while still, bringing kind of the best of.
Well, I wondered if you meant by baritone that it was a lower pitch.
Yeah, I know that word is like thrown around a lot. I know a lot of companies have baritone this, and I've seen a baritone in 16-inch snares and lower and baritones and other things. And you know, maybe it's a word that's a little bit overused already, but we like it and we're sticking with it. So
what is this one?
This one is a 14 by 6.5 jar. So basically, here is your regular 14 by 6.5 jar block. This is your 14 by 6.5 jar block.
Well, I want to hit both of them. Can I do that?
Absolutely. Drop that one. That's fairly high tuned.
But still, I can actually feel and hear that.
Yeah, the oomph through it.
Definitely. That one will.
Yeah.
It will come up.
Oh, it will come way up. We usually play when we send them out. We usually put them up quite a few notches than that.
Okay, and this one.
Okay, this is special. This is a 13 by 7, what we call a hybrid, which is alternating blocks of Jarrah and one of the new timbers we're working with, which is lemon-scented gum. Mm. Now, I've put lemon-scented gum out on Facebook a little bit over the past couple weeks, and you get the inevitable, can you lick it? Can you eat it? Does it smell? Does it smell like lemons when you pull it out of the box? Generally no to all of those. However, as a tree, yes, that is its real name. It is a lemon-scented gum, and when you crush the leaves, they definitely smell like lemons. Phenomenal tree, very dense timber, very, very sturdy. You actually do see some of these trees in especially around Los Angeles, because like most great Australian trees, you put them in the ground and then they don't need to do anything. They just adapt, so they can go without any other water other than what may come to them in winter. And they don't just sort of, they thrive, they go through the roof. So they are a really good species that has managed to be successfully transplanted outside of Australia because of its awesome.
Now to back up a second, is that maybe what makes the Australian hardwoods that dense because of lower moisture?
Well, the country in itself, it's a really It's a really strange country from a geographical and an ecological
point
of view.
You said that, I didn't.
Oh, no, I take full responsibility for that. Well, you do the comparisons. Australia is roughly the same size as the United States, except there's nothing in the middle of Australia. There's Western Australia, which is on this side, if this is your Australia. And there's Darwin up the top and South Australia all the way down here. And then a couple other coastal towns. You've got your Brisbane at the top, Sydney, Melbourne, and Tasmania down the bottom, which also has awesome black art trees. But the further inland you go, the more challenging it gets if you're anything that needs to survive. That includes, it goes for animals as well, but certainly it goes for any sort of flora that's out there. Okay. It's basically desert, so the trees that do grow out there, they basically have to adapt or they die. So if they can't survive without, being in sort of, be it sandy soil or on occasions clay and getting no water whatsoever, then they're just going to die and they're not going to exist. So you do find that a lot of the species, as you go further inland, they're generally more dense because they have to grow. They have to go big and strong and tonka tough just to make it in the world.
It makes sense.
Yeah.
It makes sense. And what is this one then?
Okay. This is a 14x8, a man's drum, as my dad likes to say about a 14x8. 14x8 lemon-scented gum hybrid baritone block snare. And we are debuting them here today. There's been no lemon-scented baritones, and we thought we'd bring them out for a little bit of a show and tell. We're generally not releasing the baritone block snares until next year, but we wanted to give you all a bit of a sneak peek. And I'm dying over the 13. It's just gorgeous.
Let me play a note or two on these. Can I do that, Alan? Here's the 7x13.
So, welcome to the world, baritones.
This feels amazing.
Yeah.
I mean,
I heard before it left, the boys said,
wow.
The 14x8.
Wow.
Definitely.
I mean, I know it sounds good, but I mean, this is fun to play.
Yeah.
I love the way this one, it's just got lot of great bite.
Mm-hmm.
And just such a solid feel, but this one, I don't know. Ooh. I can't have two, can I?
Yeah.